This bridge, which is under construction to the east of Lichfield, is currently the most northern structure on the HS2 route which is being built. There is some work going ahead north of here, but the A38 bridge is currently the only major structure which is under construction north of the Fulton Wood Bridge that was moved into place in 2023. The construction of the bridge that will take the A38 over HS2 is a key structure, which is actually part of a series of structures which have had to be built within a short distance. Within just 1.2 kilometres, HS2 must cross the West Coast Main Line, the South Staffordshire Line and the A38. In July 2023, a massive 6,200-tonne bridge section was moved into place, which will take the HS2 tracks under the West Coast Main Line. Another 2,600-tonne bridge span was also moved into place 1 kilometre to the north, to take the South Staffordshire Line over HS2. Immediately to the north of the railway, HS2 must cross under the A38 and the southbound exit slip road, with less than 50 metres between the Staffordshire Line and southbound exit slip. For this reason, Balfour Beatty Vinci JV has chosen to build a 420 metre long retained cut, which passes underneath the railway and will pass underneath the A38. The structure was originally going to be around 1.6 kilometres long, but the design was refined to reduce the size and therefore reduce the amount of concrete required. The retaining structure is being built in a similar way to part of the structure through Burton Green, which I spoke about a few weeks ago. To build the retaining structure, engineers are first having to install 1,014 secant piles. I explained what secant piles are in the most recent Burton Green video. But basically, they're interlocking piles which alternate between reinforced and non-reinforced, which leaves behind a strong watertight wall section. When I visited Lichfield in November last year, it was possible to see the piling rig working in between the southbound exit slip and the main A38 carriageway, which was realigned so the retaining wall and bridge structure could be built. The steel cylinders, which are being driven into the ground by the piling rig, are temporary casings, which support the wall of the pile bore until it is filled with concrete. Then, once the concrete is poured, the casing is removed. An auger is used to remove the material from within the casing, with the piling rig boring the hole and installing the casing at the same time. To remove the material from within the casing, the auger is lifted out, which lifts all of the material with it. A new casing section is then lifted into position and the boring cycle starts again. Just to the west of the entry slip, you can see a completed section of the retaining structure, or at least the top of the capping beam and the props that have been built to resist lateral movement and stop the walls from moving inwards. The material from within the structure was yet to be removed when I visited, and the concrete layer you may be able to see is a blinding layer upon which the props were built. Once the retaining structure, which is currently being constructed, is finished, the bridge deck will be built in situ on top, and then the carriageway will be realigned to its previous position. It is hoped that the main carriageway will be realigned by November this year, which will likely require the closure of the carriageway to connect the existing carriageway to the new, or rather previous, alignment. The work to tie the A38 and pre-built western sections together will require the closure of the northbound entry slip from November 2025 until September 2026. Once complete, the 420 metre long structure will support three separate spans, one for the Staffordshire Line, one for the southbound exit slip, and a larger span for the main carriageway. As you would expect with such a large and challenging build, there is a lot of activity happening on site. But less than 300 metres to the north of the A38, all seems quiet. You can clearly see the HS2 trace heading north, but the site was eerily quiet when I visited in November. And there appears to be a clear boundary between the A38 site and the northern route section. Following the rescoping of the project in 2023, little to no work had taken place on the northernmost part of the route between Lichfield and Handsacre. However, some work is taking place just over 2 kilometres to the north of the A38 site. The site, close to Woodend Lane, was or is going to be the location for the junction that was to take HS2 north, with a spur heading in a westerly direction towards the West Coast Main Line. The work happening in this location is only very early preparatory work, with the junction between Woodend Lane and Netherstone Lane being temporarily diverted. Utility diversion works are also expected to take place. The work, which is due for completion in the spring, is associated with a link road to a housing development which is currently being built. Work on the railway junction, which was or is going to be built in the area, is still paused, with no sign yet of when work will recommence. There is still very little information about what will happen with HS2 and the connection to the West Coast Main Line. But I'd hazard a guess that the junction with the stub for what would have been HS2 Phase 2 will still be built, as a complete redesign of the route at this stage would save very little money. From what little information I have heard since 2023, it was indicated that the slow line connection to the West Coast Main Line at Handsacre will be built. But again, there has been no announcement, so it's difficult to tell what will happen for certain. The only thing I can say is it now looks as if the connection to the West Coast Main Line to allow HS2 trains to travel north will be delayed by at least 3 years. There may be an announcement in the spring once the latest spending review has concluded, but it's not guaranteed. As for the site at Handsacre, it has changed very little since I visited in 2023, which is somewhat concerning. I last explained the difference between the fast and slow line connections some time ago, so for the benefit of any new viewers, the slow line connection will see the HS2 spur connected to the slow lines on the West Coast Main Line, as opposed to the fast lines, which are those currently used by Express Avanti services. The design was changed from the so-called fast line connection to the slow line design to save money, as HS2 was going to be extended to Crewe anyway, so the fast line connection was no longer deemed necessary. But with the cancellation of Phase 2, it now leaves us with a situation which could see HS2 trains heading north between Handsacre and College on the slow lines, which will have an overall impact on capacity, as this section of the existing line, with its flat junctions, is already one of the most constrained sections on the West Coast Main Line.